Which are those two planets that decide the end result? I've seen this over and over again. Yes, we have a beautiful chart, and there are so many things which we see. We have the Ascendant Lord, we have Sun, we have Moon, we have the Atmakaraka, we have the 10th Lord, we have the 7th Lord. So many planets, so many houses. Planets in the nakshatras of the Lords of the 10th, 11th, 5th, 9th, very powerful planets. But which are those two planets that decide at the end what happens? Yes, are there two planets? Yes, there are two such planets. And recently I had been talking with an astrologer, and that astrologer told me something really interesting, which I would like to share. So, which is that first planet which decides the end result? Okay. And what do I mean when I say end result? End result means whatever comes of its own accord, by dint of your karma. How do you use it? At the end, does it turn out to be good for you or does it turn out to be bad for you? Okay. So, how do you make use of the things? As they say, make the best use of a bad bargain. All right. So, today we shall discuss these two very crucial planets, which are very much ignored in Vedic astrology sometimes or most of the times. And as usual, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it down below. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your career or marriage or health, then you can go to my website down in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and he will find you will find him. Okay, so which is that first planet? Yes, undoubtedly it's Mars. Why do I say Mars? Because Mars is the he's the Karaka for the sixth house. Okay, he is a very important planet. Because what is the sixth house? Sixth house shows those enemies and those weaknesses that you can fight and you can overcome. Therefore, when Mars is strong in somebody's chart, it is rest assured that this person will do everything that is required to get the work done, okay, to have it completed. Now, disclaimer, this can also mean this is also true, this also works for criminals and for people who are doing wrong things, okay. So, when we say this, that the person completes something, it's not necessarily good always, okay. Person may complete bad things also. All right. So therefore, before you give a blind judgment, you need to look at the entire chart. Okay. But in general, if Mars is strong, then this happens. I've seen. Now, how do you determine if Mars is strong, it's weak, it's good, or it's bad? Okay. This is very important because many times you will just say, "Oh, my Mars is in Capricorn, it is in Uchcha Rashi, exaltation, blah blah blah. This happened, nothing happened, I'm very lazy, I'm this, I'm that." Okay. So you have to understand, ultimately in Vedic astrology, you have to see the house, the lords, and the nakshatras and the signs. Okay. Sometimes we just blindly see the sign and we say, "Ah, that's it. The sign is good, everything is good." Okay. It doesn't work always. Okay, not that it doesn't work, it works in a particular area, but the end result depends on so many factors which we ignore. Okay, and then we abuse astrology and astrologers and we say that their predictions don't work. All right, so we have to know how to use things in the right context. So, how do you know if Mars is good or bad or strong in your chart? Okay, strong to achieve whatever the end that could be for good or bad. Okay, but that gearing energy of Mars, is it there in the chart? How do you know that? Well, first of all, you need to check the house where he's placed. Okay, so which houses does Mars do very good in? Mars does excellent in the ascendant, I've seen. Then the third house, then he does excellent in the sixth house, and he does excellent in the 10th house. All right, these four houses I've seen, and to some extent the 11th, but I would keep it aside. These four houses, okay. So Mars is excellent if it is he's placed in these houses. He's in general very strong, okay. And also he is exalted in the sign of Capricorn, as you know. And apart from that, he is also in Mool Trikona in in Aries and own sign Scorpio. Okay, so that's the house and the sign. But then you also need to see the planets which are in trines to Mars. Okay, which planets do good? Which planets help Mars? So, for example, if there is Jupiter, Jupiter is aspecting Mars, then the person is not only geared, but geared with intelligence. So therefore, this combination is a very good combination. Jupiter, Mars in trines to each other, okay, not in trines from the ascendant necessarily, from each other. So for example, if Mars is in 12, Jupiter is in 4th or 8th as an example. Okay, this is a very good placement because the Jupiter is a great benefic and the friend of Mars. Okay, so Jupiter is helping Mars by being in the trines to Mars. Okay. And if Sun and Moon are in trines to Mars, then also it is good because they are natural friends. Okay. Then if the trinal lords, irrespective of their natural relationship with Mars, so suppose the fifth lord and the ninth lord. Okay. So for example, if somebody is a Taurus Lagna, then Mercury and Saturn, they are the fifth and the ninth lords respectively. Oh, so in that case, what happens? Even though Mercury and Saturn, they may not be having a great relationship with Mars, even then, because they are lords of the trines from the ascendant, they will definitely help Mars. Okay. Or if you see Mars is with the ascendant lord, then also it's good. Okay. Or if you see that Mars is is sitting in a nakshatra whose lord is very well placed. For example, if Mars is placed in Shravan nakshatra, anywhere in the chart, okay. And who is the lord of Shravan? It's the moon. If moon is placed in the 10th house, for example, great placement. So then Mars becomes extremely strong. He's extremely powerful there. All right. So these are ways by which you can know. And the last way is very important, as I always keep saying, the nakshatras. Okay. And also we check how Mars is in the Navamsha. So once you have seen all this, then you know how Mars is. Okay. So then now your Mars will never be always powerful, always weak. Okay? It will have certain good things, it will have certain weaknesses. So then you must be able to identify where is the strength and where is the weakness. And once you identify the strong points of Mars, then you need to know where, which area of life, how do you need to use it for. So for example, if Mars is in the 10th house, it can be excellent for caring, but it could be a disaster for marriage. Okay. So therefore, the same planet which is giving you success in one area of life may give you failure in another area of life. So just because Mars is strong in the 10th house, it's in Digbala, it doesn't mean it's great for marriage. Okay, it's terrible actually for marriage. All right. Now, once you have seen Mars, Mars will tell you inherently how much is the person ready to fight, all right? But just fighting is not enough. You need, anybody can fight, you know, we can just keep fighting all day and night. But we also need something which is skill, and that's the second planet, Mercury. Mercury is very important. A long time back, the great astrologer Ryan Kurzak, he had come to my channel. Years back actually, and he said that he gives very much importance to Mercury. Okay, because irrespective of how things are, if Mercury is good in the chart, then it's great. Why Mercury is the karaka for the 10th house. 10th house is the house where the sun gets directional strength. Okay, and what is the sun? Sun is the karaka for name, fame, power, position, authority, success, respect, all these things. So therefore, to the extent Mercury is well placed, you can check the same factors when it comes to Mercury. Okay, of course, for the exception that if Saturn, Venus, they are in trines to Mercury, then Mercury really gets help. But of course, Venus won't be in trines to Mercury because they are always very close. But at least if Saturn is there, or if the trinal lords, even if they may be natural enemies to Mercury, okay? Or where is Mercury's nakshatra lord sitting, okay? So therefore, Mercury is the planet which can give you a lot of name and fame, and it can make you do the right things. Mars makes you do things, okay? Mercury makes you do the right things, okay? And if Mercury is good, you know what to do. But if Mars is not good, you don't do it. And in Mercury is the other way around also. Sometimes, you know, you can have so much information, but you may not do. And sometimes you may have a lot of courage and power and vigor and strength and enthusiasm, but you don't know what to do. Okay. So therefore, apart from all the standard principles of astrology, these two planets are very crucial. I always check whenever somebody asks me like questions like, all right, will I become a millionaire or a billionaire, or, you know, these things are there. These are the problems. Will I be successful? So then, of course, we need to check that particular area of life, but we must check these two planets. Okay. Do not ignore Mars. Do not ignore Mercury. Because Mercury is the character for skill. He gives you the intelligence by which you know when to do what. Okay. But of course, just being intelligent is not good enough. You also need the help of Jupiter. Okay. So ultimately, it's the overall chart which matters. But at a ground level, when you talk for materialistic success, especially I've seen in areas of finances. Why? Because Mercury is the character for the 10th house. And Mars is the original lord of the first house. You see, Aries. Mars is the body. The body wants things, necessities, luxuries in life. Okay. Therefore, these two planets are really very crucial. Okay. So if you have cutthroat competition, if you want to get success, if you want to go ahead and away from the crowd, do something which nobody has ever done, then you need these two planets. Okay, you need Mars, you need Mercury, and if you want to be revolutionary, then Rahu is needed, Uranus is needed, okay, something where people can be absorbed, then Neptune is needed. These are the things which I've seen. All right. So there you go. God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So if you want a consultation from me, you can go to my website down in the description section, and other videos on Mars and Mercury, I'll put them here. All right. Jai Shri Ram.